Welcome to part two of our Lymphatic System series on lymphatic malformations by the Vascular Anomalies Center at Children's Hospital, Colorado. Click here to watch part one, which explains how the lymphatic system works, or check out the description below. A lymphatic malformation is when the lymphatic system doesn't form correctly, causing parts of the body to swell. Since it occurs before birth, it's a congenital or primary condition and is usually visible by early childhood or more rarely later in life. It can vary greatly between people and can change appearance over time. To many, this swelling can be emotionally distressing, socially isolating, and difficult to understand. When we form in the womb, our cells read our DNA, or blueprints, to build everything in our bodies, including the blood and lymphatic systems, the two mass transit systems of our bodies. If the blueprint is misread or contains errors, the lymphatics get built incorrectly and are malformed. This is why it's called a lymphatic malformation. Terms like cystic hygroma and lymphangioma, while still widely used, are outdated and incorrect because they suggest some relation to cancer. A lymphatic malformation is not cancer and does not become cancerous. There are many kinds of lymphatic malformations. First, cystic lymphatic malformations are lymphatics that were built incorrectly. The lymph piles up like a traffic jam, forming a group of bubbles, which we call cysts. They can be microcystic, meaning tiny bubbles, macrocystic, meaning big bubbles, or mixed. The microcystic type form in clusters and are very small and sponge-like. If near the skin, they may appear as small blisters called blebs. The macrocystic type are larger than about 2 centimeters and can become much larger. They look like soft, smooth, translucent bubbles under the skin and may tint the skin slightly blue. They can be painful and put pressure on other parts of the body. Both types can form anywhere in the body, but most often form near major lymphatic channels, especially near the neck and armpits. CCLAs, or central conducting lymphatic anomalies, are when the central lymphatics, the main central highway that transports chyle from the intestines, is malformed. Much larger traffic jams form, and the body tries to relieve the pressure by building new routes anywhere it can, even taking side streets. These new routes don't reach the heart, however, and the lymph pools up again, and some pools may leak into the chest or abdomen. When this happens, fats, proteins, immune cells, and other important passengers can't get to their destinations, which over time starts to cause health problems throughout the body. In the chest, this is called a chylothorax, which can cause a cough, discomfort in the chest, and difficulty breathing. In the abdomen, it's called chylous ascites. The abdomen can become very large, full, and painful. Lymphatic malformations may not become visible until later in life, and many things can change their appearance. For example, when an injury occurs, immune cells are sent to the affected area. If the injury gets infected, even more immune cells are sent. If a cyst is nearby, it can swell or even fill up with blood, changing its appearance. The infection itself can also cause redness, swelling, and pain. A cyst may also expand slowly with age or more rapidly during puberty. There are many ways to treat a lymphatic malformation depending on its cause. First, The cyst may be observed over time to see if it deflates on its own. Next, sclerotherapy can help macrocystic lymphatic malformations shrink or collapse. While asleep under general anesthesia, the cyst is partially deflated. And a medication is injected that irritates it, causing scar tissue to form. This irritation lasts for about 2 to 3 days, and usually swells for 1 to 2 weeks. Over about a month, the cyst starts to shrink as the scar tissue grows. Multiple treatments may be needed depending on the extent of the malformation. If the cyst is limited to a small enough area, part of it can be removed by surgery. This option depends on many factors, like how nearby organs would be affected by the surgery. Unless the malformation is limited to a small area, sclerotherapy and surgery will not completely repair it, and flare-ups of swelling can still happen. These symptoms can be managed, however, but need long-term monitoring. Finally, medications may help slow the flow of lymph and soften the cyst. This helps organize the traffic jams, allowing them to drain. This is an active field of research, and places like Children's Hospital Colorado are helping future medications become more targeted, personalized, and effective. Our team is ready to work with you to best understand and treat your lymphatic malformation. To learn more, contact the Vascular Anomalies Center by visiting our website below.